Hello and welcome to this presentation on Design of Experiments, DOE, in ADS. In the simplest term, Design of Experiments, DOE, helps to pinpoint for you the sensitive parts and sensitive areas in your designs that cause problems in the yield. So as a designer, you are then able to fix them and produce rock solid and robust designs with much higher yield. So let me show you how Design of Experiments, or DOE, does that for you. Here is a brief tutorial on DOE. Let's say we have a design, and in this design we choose three variables. So in this case I choose a microstrip width of lines W, resistor R, and a capacitor C. So we have three variables: width of line, resistor, capacitor. And they all, the three variables, have nominal value, and with process variation they change plus or minus, for the resistor and capacitor, plus or minus 5%, and for the width of the line it changes plus or minus half a micron. So for the width of the line here, let's say the nominal value is 10 micron. So 0 corresponds to 10 micron. If I say minus 1, this corresponds to the nominal value, but we subtract that tolerance or that process variation, half a micron. You see the plus or minus half a micron here? So the minus 1 corresponds to 9.5 micron, and the plus 1 would be the high end, which is 10.5 micron. Same thing with the resistor and the capacitor. A 0 would be the nominal value for the resistor and the capacitor. A plus 1 would be the nominal value plus 5%, and the minus 1 would be the nominal value minus 5%. Okay, so let's move on. In Design of Experiments, for a full factorial, the number of experiments you want to run is 2 to the number of elements, 2 to the power of how many elements we have. So, for example, we have WRC, those are three components. The number of experiments for a full factorial is 2 to the third, which is 8 experiments. So, when we put a table like this, we set WRC, and we put all the combinations of the minus 1 and the plus 1 that covers the 8 experiments. And the first line, notice here I have 0, 0, 0, that means it's the nominal values of WRC. Under nominal values, when I simulate my amplifier, I get 13.8 dB gain. That's the nominal value. Then I put everything, W and R and C, to minus 1. That means it's minus 5% of the nominal value on for C and R, and minus half a micron for W. And I simulate and I get different gain. Then I change just one at a time. I keep minus 1, minus 1. I change this to plus 1 and I get a different gain. So I get all the combinations of simulations for the three variables. And I get the gain value right here. Once I do this, these are the experiments, the 8 experiments. Once I do this, then I have this table. Notice in the table here that the first top 4 experiments have capacitor as minus 1, and the bottom 4 experiments have capacitor plus 1. We get, for C minus 1 in the yellow, we get an average gain, the average of these gains, 13.7725 dB. But for C equal plus 1, the average gain would be, right here in the blue, 13.86 dB. So we calculate the slope per unit, and we find out that it changes, the gain changes by 0.044 dB per one unit. Now, let's do the same thing for the resistor, R. In the blue, we see all the minus 1s for the R, for the resistor. In the green, we see the plus 1 for R. We do the same thing. We take the blue, take the average, and we take the average in the green section. Okay, so for R minus 1, we get 12.97 dB. That's the blue. for R equal 1 plus 1, we get 14.6625 dB, which is the green. Now we calculate the slope for this, and we get 0.85 dB per unit. So we plot these for to see it much easier. So you can see the amplifier gain on the y-axis, and we have minus 1 to plus 1. The blue line is represent the resistor, the gain change due to the resistor, and the red one is due to the capacitor. Easily you can see that the resistor is contributing more variation in gain than the capacitor. So these are called the main effect plot. So when I talk in DOE about main effects or effects plots, they look like this. Okay? Next we move to the next page, and let's now see the interaction effect. So basically now I'm giving you an example of interaction effect between W, the width of the line, and the resistor R. So I take W and R columns, and notice the pink color is plus 1, because you multiply minus 1 times minus 1 is plus 1, 1 times 1 is plus 1, minus 1 times minus 1 is plus 1, etc. All the pink is plus 1. And the blue, when you multiply them, it's minus 1. So for the interaction, you do the same thing. You find the average gain for WR equal minus 1, and the average gain for WR equal plus 1. And you find the slope of the change in gain, and we notice the slope is very small. So the interaction effect between W and R is not really contributing much to the variation in gain. And if we plot it on the next page, notice in pink, this is almost a horizontal line. It really has no effect in the gain. But the resistor, the dominant effect here for the gain. So we do the same thing, what I showed you, to all the components. And you can see, you can construct a linear equation that represents these experimental results. So we can say our gain is 13.8 dB, which is the nominal value we calculated early on, plus 0.09W, because the factor here is plus, is positive, plus 0.85R. Sometimes you get a negative number. You could get a negative slope. But in our case here, we get positive slopes. Plus 0.044C plus, etc. You just construct a whole equation here that would give you a lot of information on the gain versus the variation in all the components you chose. And the best way to see this is by plotting them on a Pareto chart. So when you do it in a Pareto chart, easily you can identify right now that the resistor R and the W, the width of the lines, are the top two contributors to the change in gain, to the variation in gain. So I can concentrate first as a designer on the resistor R. What can I do to the this resistor to make it less sensitive? In Mimic, I can make it much wider. It's like if my resistor is 10 micron wide, I can make it 20 micron or 30 micron wide. This would reduce its sensitivity. If I fix this R resistor problem, I will not have big variation and sensitivity in my design. Conclusion here, again, in very simple words, design of experiments will help you to pinpoint the sensitive parts and the sensitive area in your design that cause the problems in the yield and cause problems in achieving first pass success. So once you identify these sensitive parts and sensitive areas, then designers are able to fix them and produce a rock solid, robust designs, and it will give you a first pass success. Let me now show you a demo in ADS, a simple demo just to see how in ADS you can use the design of experiments.